in my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people in my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah. Feel like Ginger from Casino. Aces up my sleeve, though. Right before I leave, I said like I'm Eno. Think I'm part Italian, blame it on Gino. Snowflake the medallion, the skin on cappuccino. I don't kiss and tell, keep your distance from myself. Had a genie with the snails in a five-star hotel. And I wish he's well when they wish for me to fail. I might donate petty bills, they can't get it by they sell.
That's why you treat my friend good, but not too good. I give him too much, then they don't need me.
Yeah, I just ran a check up on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And a finest man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. By myself, these I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself. Yeah. I'ma get it either way. I don't even gotta say what I want when I want. They just put it on my plate. I could get it right away. Take you through my day to day. Wake and pray, make that play. Get some good at my place. There's some on the way. Cause my bro's on the way. I got stones on my gold. I got loads in my safe. Had a 7-figure summer, so I'm putting on some weight. Set up. Getting thick, so I put it on display.
What is wrong? I make a joke, everybody laughs. I know I'm funny, but I'm not that funny.
Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head up to my nails. I'ma get it by myself, yeah.
Level up at any moment. Spitting like a semi, only give me semicolon. Couple zeros like I'm sending yell nets. Every flow is unmatched, and I better get set in. Finish him, finish him.
Messing around with me and I diminish them all. Even if I ever did the minimum all.
In the end result, I'm better killing them all. Rogue one, but I got a team with me. Batman when I got a thing with me. I get mean, I get green. Show the whole game what's never been seen. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank.
Okay, Coach, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Hoosier State and Lucas Oil Stadium in downtown Indianapolis. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Indianapolis Colts. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line.
Let's go, boy. Let's go. First and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Set, ready? 10, 2, stop.
Let's go one more. Check safety, check safety.
2.
They'll run on first down. Swift, 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Now a give, right side, Swift, and this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6. This defense looking for an early stop. This is 3rd down and 6.
Scott, 961, match box, white. Check. Press down.
From the gun, Stevens. Yeah, that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
It's taken to the 26. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Colts will go on offense here, 1st and 10. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10.
He's not going to get me. Why? Get wide. Deep grip.
They'll run for the first time with Johnson. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. A 14-yard gain for Indianapolis and also move the sticks.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it could be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
They stay on the ground on first with Johnson. And he works his way forward for about 4 up to the midfield stripe.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down. A very solid gain on that play. At the 50-yard line.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6.
Go!
Mike 54!
Get it!
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. It's complete here to T.Y. Hilton. And he's going to have another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 30.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Ready. 30 base.
54.
Man, I got you.
Watch twist.
The 1st down carry here for Johnson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That's good for an Indianapolis 1st down on a gain of 10.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
15, Ronnie.
Let's get off the field, D. Hey, watch it.
Let's go.
Naeem Hines, his 1st carry. He'll get forward for 3 down to the 16-yard line.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
I got you, son.
Hey, lock it.
Watch the ship. Hey, watch the ship.
Ready.
Here's a 2nd and 7. And nearly an interception here on their opening drive. But instead, 3rd down. He was all over that route defensively. Now, they had 2 picks last week as a unit. Couldn't quite grab that one.
Patience, Grasshopper. Patience. It's early in this game, but you like the fact that they're around the football early. They're going to be upset they didn't haul that one in. But at least they're there at the moment of truth to make a play.
By the way, where did the... And he'll get into the end end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Paris Campbell with touchdown number 7 on the year, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Extra point right down the middle, and it's now a 7-0 game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10.
Let's put that team on the clock. 36. He's coming.
Two jet bombers. Hey, world.
Shoot. Off the play fake. Stevens. And he's going to be taken down. Sacked back at the 2.
I spent a lot of extra time preparing for this game, watching this offensive line, because they gave up 5 sacks last week in their loss. They just gave up another one now. They don't seem to be working together as a cohesive unit. Right? 4 guys might have it right, but the 5th guy is giving something up. They've got to find a way to all get on the same page.
And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time, because let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Let's take it inside his own 40. Very good return that time. 18 yards. And the Colts are set up well as they take over 1st and 10 on the short side of the field.
Break. Check Mike 54. Watch the screen. Check 37.
On 1st down, Hines. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling, and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
2nd and 3. Looking for Campbell downfield. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
This team doesn't mind running the ball in any situation, and I thought he was going to get the 1st down the way the play developed, but the defense closed in and stopped him just about a yard short.
Would have been a decently long field goal, 51 yards from here, but instead they're going to go for it. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's got Jack Doyle. And he picks up the 1st before he's taken down at the 29. A solid pickup of 5 and a very solid 4th down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration.
Ready to break.
Mike 54. I can't believe they even let you play.
Sit up.
Check Mike 54. Mike 54.
Bristol travel. Look at me. Go on.
25.
They'll look to throw here on 1st down. He's got it to Hilton. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. It'll be a gain of 17 and an Indianapolis 1st down.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Running from the gun, Johnson. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. David Johnson with touchdown number 20 on the year. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
The Jaguars take over first down 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Ready? Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board.
Now a man open down the middle of the field and up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 10 yards there, good enough for a Jags first down. He missed on his first three passes, was 0-for-3. Now gets a connection, maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern because once you start in a certain pattern, you wonder, can you get out of it? And that flips the other way too when you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion. They think he might be off to the races.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Well, it certainly appears that they're going to try and keep getting him the football. That's the third time they've looked in his direction. Unfortunately, haven't completed one yet, but I'm not sure they're going to shy away from him. They feel like they've got something there, and they want to capitalize on it.
I think you're right. We're only in the first quarter, so a lot of opportunities ahead. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Now a 3rd down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
They begin the drive with Johnson. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2. And it brings up second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
From the 22, here's 2nd and 8.
Hey, I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you.
Here's 2nd and 8. Catch made here by Campbell. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Good yardage there for the Colts. 18 and a first down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route.
Keep it up, defense. Keep it up, guys.
80 weapons.
Get it.
They'll run on first down. It's Hines. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Second and one. And the catch made by Hilton. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 37.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. Now Johnson. A little too much extracurricular there.
When you have a game with a lot of contact, tensions are going to run pretty high. You're going to be emotional, but you have to harness it somehow, and he didn't on that play.
Down. 18 Gators. X3. 218. Chopper. Hey, Alpha.
Hey, it's all right.
54.
Ready, ready.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Josh Allen, what a season he continues to have. His 15th sack of the campaign.
Well, maybe that can give him a little bit of a pick-me-up, a little bit of a jolt. One of the few things has gone right defensively.
Because other than that, it's really been a first half to forget. After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here.
Hey, Charlie!
They're going to look to throw, letting one go deep. And he's got his tight end. That's Ebron, and it's a Cook touchdown. Eric Ebron. Hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. Point after, right down the middle. And it's now 21 to nothing. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down 3 scores. A 3-and-out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw. Because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Complete to Hilton. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That's good for an Indianapolis first down on a gain of 10. This quarterback now 8 of 11 in this first half. He's got it first and 10. He'll look to throw. And his His throw here is incomplete. He was looking that time to get it to Paris Campbell, but it's going to be second down.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Here's Hines. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
10 Tucson. Mike 54.
Hey, D-line, let's get in there. Let's get in that half.
Hit it.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Johnson. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Just a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. To punt on fourth down, here's Rigoberto Sanchez. Back deep for the Jags, D.D. Westbrook. He was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're down.
You don't want to.
I know, but hold on, let me finish.
Okay, my bad.
You're down 3 scores already. You've done nothing offensively, nothing on the scoreboard. That's not a good combination.
I think you just called it. I think you just called it desperation time.
I think you did.
But let's face it, you mentioned this to me in a break earlier in the game. The energy level hasn't been there right from the start. We've noticed that. They've got to find a way to get on their toes and start punching instead of retreating, to use a boxing analogy.
And now the throw taken in by Chark. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line.
Well, for teams that like to play man coverage, running corner routes can be tough on them because of the ability of getting into it. Sometimes you're squaring it off. Sometimes you're just rounding it. Sometimes there's a fake. Sometimes there's not. That makes it very, very difficult for a DB to stay with it.
Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1. The Jaguars on 3rd down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. A 3rd down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. And again, this time to the tailback. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
On 2nd down, Armstead. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at 3rd and 1. The Jaguars on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's got the 1st down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. He needed a yard, that's what he got, and it's going to earn him a new set of downs. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43. You mentioned very early on the need to establish a running game for this young QB. They really haven't been able to do that, though, in the first half.
So that means what in halftime? Adjustments. Time, right? Figure out what they are. Figure out the things that they really want to accomplish and who to run behind. Which are your better blockers? find those guys and get in that direction.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third.
Deep grip.
Operating from the gun, Stevens going up top. And he can't quite intercept it. Zone coverage, free safety was there. Couldn't come up with it, and now it's fourth down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Taken at about the 16. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Eight yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple.
Pilot, 64, weak.
Second and 2. Campbell making the catch. He's exceeded his receiving yards from a week ago, and we're still in the first half. It's a first down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch. But you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Check.
22 Jeff Bomber. Hey, high 7. 5.
Back to throw. Over the middle, hauled in by Campbell. That one for Indianapolis, resulting in 15 yards and a fresh set of downs. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. On first down, Hines. And he'll be taken down after a short gain as that takes us to the 2-minute warning. Remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL.
Ready.
Now a 10th carry for Johnson, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Now on the heels of that run by Johnson, here's another first and 10.
You might be getting tired of seeing me.
Now a handoff here to his running back. He will push his way down to about the 14. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority 1.
The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. They'll look to throw here. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trumaine Johnson. They were looking for Johnson that time.
Those INTs all sting, but you throw one in the red zone, I think especially as a rookie, maybe it stings a little bit more.
I think what you're saying is they don't all count the same, do they? Right? Interceptions in the red zone that you've given up points now, those are precious. So you have to learn from those and in a hurry.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
Back to the air on second down. Stevens. He rifles one that's intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half. I mean, that just didn't happen. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
Six man. Check curls, check curls, check
curls.
Go! You.
Hey, Echo! Defense!
They'll drop the throw. Eluding the, nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Jags grab it. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line.
With no running backs in the backfield to help pass protect, all the receivers in their patterns, it's going to be hot routes. If they sense a blitz or pressure on the quarterback, they've got to be prepared to break routes off early and get the football. In this case,
nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. That one complete to Dede Westbrook. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. On third down, Stevens. He's going to let this go for the end zone. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. This is Josh Lambeau. He hit from 57 a year ago. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with 3.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
And solid field position here to start as they get it out to the 40-yard line. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. Time remaining for likely one final play. You're on your side of the field, but, you know, heck, maybe you throw one up 50-plus yards, see what happens.
Don't forget that taking the knee is the right play to make, because you just get out of there, you regroup, you start over. But if you're going to take the shot, you do have a chance of either making the play happen or picking up a deep pass interference call. And remember, it's the NFL. You get yardage. It's not just a 15-yard play. You could have something big here. Let's see if they take the shot.
Get ready. Get ready. Get ready.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. This quarterback now 12 of 17 through the air as he leads his guys up on first down. They'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Campbell. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. An excellent pickup of 20 yards. They'll run on first down. It's Hines. They'll wind up getting four down to the 36.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Second and six. Ebron caught left side. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. The catch and run there, good for 16 in the first. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
60 or. Hey, Delta.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
It's a gain of 9. Brings out second and a yard at the 11-yard line.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one.
Let's go, defense. And here we go.
Now. He'll drop to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him. Made it very tough for him to get the ball.
They tried to throw on second down. Unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. They run with Hines. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Ready? 60 outlaw.
Go. Check it back.
Hey, Sam off.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Jalen Ramsey. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They've got a pretty comfortable lead right now, but maybe a little too careless with the football that time for the rookie.
I think the key word there is comfortable. And there's two schools of thought on it. With that type of a lead, maybe you can take a few more chances because you have a cushion. Others will tell you, don't eat up the cushion with careless play. He'll learn to ride that line as he moves on in his career.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. From the gun, Stevens. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. This one complete into the hands of Higgins.
And another thing that makes the comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receivers breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. Nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
On first down, nothing opening up really on the running play. Give him maybe a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got just pin their ears back and get after him now.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target in the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him. Find him.
The open man is Shark. It's complete. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts' 45-yard line.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you go lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes this forward for about six. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Brings up second and four.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
They're running it.
Hey, Haywood.
Off play action. Stevens. He's going to fire one deep over the... And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off inside the 10. And the return goes up to his own 17-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning, threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's the guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
The last run got nine. That leaves him with second and a yard.
Whip. Watch the whip.
Deep grip.
Again, it's Johnson. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Hey, switch gear.
Here's Johnson. And some room to work. Good yardage there for the Colts. 18 and a first down.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
Here we go. 60 Pittsburgh. 80 weapons.
Pick your game up. Check 99.
Get it.
On first down, Hines. And he's going to take this across midfield into Jacksonville territory. Tackle that time by Ronnie Harrison.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest game, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Set, ready? AT Gator.
I think you got it, son.
Man, left.
We got four.
Five.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right, and that's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
So now. After the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six.
Hey, exit.
54.
They'll set up a throw. That's complete to the running back, Nyheim Hines. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
And being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
Off the play fake. Stevens. This one caught by his tight end, Oliver. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
And, partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. And to give this time to the tailback. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 10 yards there, good enough for the Jags' first down. The CD a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field, but man, his first step is so quick too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Throwing again, Stevens. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 21. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line.
Boy, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game, go to the press conference, meet it head on, and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity.
At the 24-yard line.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven.
Me and you all day. All day. I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you. Jim, Jim.
From the gun, a run for Johnson. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Colts on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This time it's third and three.
54 is Mike, 54 is Mike. Check, check, watch 54, watch 54.
Got an Alpha.
Come on, QB, come on.
Get it.
He'll look to throw. And he's got his man, Hilton. It was third and short, and they go flying past the marker for a gain of nearly 30 yards. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
Jack! Jack!
Squeeze! Hey, Charlie! Five!
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And lucky to get away with one there. That one nearly picked.
Second down. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise or throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield. Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
The Colts on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 9.
Hey, Foxtrot.
Now back to throw. Got an open man. That's Campbell. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 32-yard line. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Here's Johnson. He's been busy this afternoon. A.J. Boye up to make the tackle.
They're a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. They go to Johnson again. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. And he's got it all the way down to the 12-yard line. Good yardage there for the Colts. 18 and a first down.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10.
Look at me. Go on.
Looking to throw. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete. The linebacker, Telvin Smith, able to get a hand on it there. They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. Now a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10.
You're going to see me in your nightmare.
They're going to look to throw. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his 2nd of the game. Instead, 4th down.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on 3rd down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. 3rd down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the 4th.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points. But this widens it out, as you said. And now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. DJ Reader able to record his 5th sack of the season. The sack cost him only 1 yard. It's 2nd and 11. 2nd and 11. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4. You got the big lead defensively.
willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Looking left side, he's got it, complete. And he'll be corralled right around the 34.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to one.
Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 16 yards that time on the pickup for the Jags, and a first down.
Set up. 10-2 stop.
Let's go, D. Tighten up. Let's go, D.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. Well, this is how you shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4-for-4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row, I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
And now the throw taken in by Chark. And he gets it down to the 32. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Operating from the gun, Stevens. And an alley to run. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
As a rookie quarterback, that's exactly how you endear yourself to your teammates. Give it up for the cause. It's also how you end up on the training table, too.
Yeah, it's a catch-22. Coach doesn't like it. Teammates love it. Where do you fall on it?
Well, I fall on wanting to endear yourself to your teammates, but pick your spots. Be smart about it. They need you for the full season.
Yeah, the rookie's going to learn as he goes. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. From the 21, it's second and 10.
General West.
Shoot. Off play action. Stevens. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage. No gain.
To throw on third down, Stevens. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Frank Clark in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year. And you hate to say it with a rookie quarterback. He's done some good things, but overall, looked a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has, but in his defense, he hadn't had a lot of time to throw the football. You like the way I said that? In his defense.
In his defense. I got it. Yeah. He needs better protection, that's for sure. And he completes it to Westbrook. Wow, first and goal, and defensively, all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. Back to throw. Stevens. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense that's well-coordinated. The front and the back really in sync. The front putting on the pressure. The backside being ball hawks and picking passes off.
Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to third and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. From 8 yards out, and the Jaguars make some inroads here on that deficit.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
Go now.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They've been pretty anemic on this side of the football in the second half, just 3 points, and you just saw the touchdown go the other way, so it's a two-score game. We're not done here yet.
I think everyone's on the edge of their seats now because they're anticipating what's coming, and I sense that everyone in the stadium knows they need to keep it on the ground. So if you're going to do that, hope the quarterback is stretched a little bit. Some bootlegs, right? Some fakes inside, getting after the perimeter. Those might be open for him.
So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. Here's a 20th carry for Johnson. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to bring up a 3rd and about 7 left. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. And the Jags with 5 in the secondary now on 3rd down.
Watch twins. Watch twins.
Ready, ready.
Now it's Hines. Oh, and they had him stopped short of the first, but a penalty marker down. And that looked like a clear face mask to me. Maybe a critical mistake at this juncture as now they've got a 1st and 10.
Let them know, let them know. Showing it, showing it.
Following the penalty, it's Johnson. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. They're down here in the 4th, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
Now it's 1st and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. They'll run it with Johnson, and he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw through 3 quarters, no reason to lighten up now. So they come up on 2nd down, if they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. Johnson. And he'll go down at the 28. A gain of 5, good enough for the 1st down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the 4th as it was way back in the 1st, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
So this one winds up an Indianapolis victory, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that.